alaikum. I am Dr. Farzana Khanum, Assistant Professor, Department of Anatomy, Boshantara Adin Medical College. In last lecture, we have given you about the main basic structure of the breast. Now, in this lecture, we will going to give a lecture about the blood supply, venous drainage and lymphatic drainage with their clinical importance or applied anatomy of the breast. Blood supply of the breast. Breast is supplied by the branch of axillary artery, internal thoracic artery and posterior intercostal artery. In medial side, it is supplied by the branch of the internal thoracic artery, and in lateral and posterior side, it is supplied mainly by the lateral thoracic branch of the axillary artery, and the other branch are superior thoracic artery and acromiothoracic artery. And in the posterior and lower portion, it is supplied by the posterior intercostal arteries. Venous drainage, same name as the artery, that the venous drainage is the axillary vein, internal thoracic vein and anastomotic venous circle. So, in case of vein, there is an important that if any carcinoma occurs in the breast, it goes to the vertebra through the venous system. This is very important line, we should remember this. Now, the main topics of our today's lecture is the lymphatic drainage. This is very important because if any carcinoma occurs in the breast, this is spread through the lymphatic pathway. It is spread to the other breast or any other organ in the abdomen or even other sort of site of the body. So, lymphatic drainage consists of lymph node. In lymph node, it consists of axillary lymph node, major lymph node, that is the 85% sentinel lymph node. The axillary lymph node consists of anterior, posterior, lateral, central, apical and interpectoral. Internal mammary or parasternal lymph node 10% and others 5%, that is supraclavicular, deltopectoral, posterior intercostal, subdiaphragmatic and subperitoneal. This is a picture showing the different lymph node of the axillary lymph node, internal mammary lymph node. And in breast, there are two types of vessels, that is called lymphatics, superficial lymphatics and deep lymphatics. Superficial lymphatics, area of drainage ki ki hobe, drain the area, drain the skin over the breast except nipple and areola. Tale superficial ta kotha theke nibe, nibe hoche skin over the breast except nipple and areola. In deep lymphatics, drains the parenchyma of the breast. Tale kotha theke nibe, drains the parenchyma of the breast, also drain the nipple and areola. In superficial lymphatics, here is a picture showing superficial and deep lymphatics. There is another type, that is subareolar plexus of Sapi, is a network of lymphatics in the areola of the nipple, takes in the name of Merle Filbert Constant Sapi, a French anatomist who published his comprehensive atlas in 1874. This is a good site of injecting dyeing during a sentinel lymph node biopsy. The subareolar plexus of Sapi ki jinish, it is a network of lymphatics in the areola of the nipple. Here is another picture shows supraclavicular, subclavicular, central lymph node, subscapular lymph node, axillary lymph node, external mammary lymph node, Rotter's internal interpectoral lymph node and internal mammary lymph node. Then there is a division as we described. A breast is divided into four quadrants because of clinical and both anatomical structure, that is upper lateral and lower lateral quadrant will drain into the axillary lymph node, then it goes to the anterior lymph node, then central, then apical lymph node. This is the route of the drainage. Ami abaro bolchi, upper lateral and lower lateral quadrant drains into the axillary lymph node. Tara prothome kothay jabe, anterior axillary lymph node, tarpor jabe kothay, central, then apical. Upper medial quadrant sadharonoto drain korbe parasternal othoba supraclavicular lymph node. Lower medial quadrant drain korbe kothay? Parasternal subdiaphragmatic lymph node, subperitoneal lymph node plexus. Here is another picture showing the different type of lymphatic drainage of it. Lymphatic node in the space between the pectoralis major and minor, it is termed as interpectoral groove or Rotter's lymph node. Now, here is another picture showing the different type of lymph node and the metastatic tumor, that is the metastatic cell comes from the mammary lymph node and goes to other structure. Now, comes to our They apply the anatomy of the breast. Breast in female is a very important organ both for the mother and for the baby. But unfortunately, there are different type of carcinoma and benign disease occurs in our country and all over the world. The most important and dangerous is the breast carcinoma, and it is spread through the lymphatic drainage. From the lymphatic drainage, from the breast carcinoma, it may spread to our ovaries, then it is called secondary metastasis ovary, and it is called Puchenberg tumor. Or it may spread to the vertebrate or the venous system, it may spread to the subdiaphragmatic lymph node to the liver. Now, the lactiferous duct radially arranged from the nipple, so incision of the gland should be made in radial direction to avoid cutting through the duct. Infiltration of the ligaments of Cooper by the breast cancer cell leads to shortening, giving a purely orange appearance of the breast. This is a very much important, this is a very much important sign of carcinoma, that is POD orange. It is a French term, comes from the French. And why this occurs? Orange means there is some area is swollen due to lymphatic infiltration, due to lymphatic obstruction, and some area of the skin is become skin retraction due to infiltration of the ligament of Cooper's. Abar boltechi, infiltration of ligaments of Cooper by the breast cancer lead to giving a POD orange appearance of the breast. This is a picture of POD orange. Thank you very much. That's all about our breast anatomy.